The day that Elizabeth went to visit a dying friend was a day that changed her life. Her friend told her with a long sigh that if she had only been treated by a lady doctor, she might not be dying. The woman had been too ashamed to mention her internal problems to a man, and by the time she finally sought treatment, it was too late. Elizabeth walked away her bedside with tears and a mission in her life. Although Elizabeth's family had once been wealthy, they had run into hard times and had immigrated to the United States when Elizabeth was 11 years old. Soon after, her father died, and Elizabeth spent her teen years knowing what it meant to be needy. She had a deep compassion for others, and her compassion drove her to prepare for medical training. She took a job in teaching, and at night she read medical books. When Elizabeth finally felt she had learned enough to enter medical school, she wrote to 29 schools seeking admission. Most didn't reply, and others replied rudely that women were not meant to be doctors. Finally, a small medical college in New York put her admission to vote of the dean, professors, and students. After several hours of debate, Elizabeth was accepted. In 1849, she graduated at the top of her class, the first woman to receive a medical degree in the United States. As difficult as it had been for Elizabeth to get into medical school, it was more difficult for her to find a job. She finally was accepted as a nursing apprentice at a maternity hospital in France. There, she contracted an infection in caring for a sick baby and lost the sight of her own eye. Her hopes for a career as a surgeon was ruled out, but she still hoped to work as a physician. A prestigious hospital in London eventually accepted her for a graduate position. After 2 years in Europe, she returned to the United States and advertised, "Miss Elizabeth Blackwell, MD has just opened an office at No. 44 University Place, and is prepared to practice in every department of her profession." She received 3 letters from women asking her to call on them at their homes. When Elizabeth sought work at a large clinic, she was rejected with the reply, "Find your own dispensary," she snapped back, "I will." She rented the basement room of a Sunday school, ran ads in newspapers, and gave lectures about health care only for women. Many who attended her lectures became patients. Elizabeth had helped her younger sister Emily attend medical school and became a surgeon. Together, they worked in the clinic. They saw 300 patients their first year and 3,000 patients the second year. Over the next 90 years, more than 1 million patients were seen at the clinic Elizabeth founded. She also wrote numerous articles and gave countless speeches to women about nutrition, the need for clean air and exercise, and the importance of keeping one's body and house clean. She helped found and develop the curriculum for both nursing school and a women's medical college, where she was a professor of hygiene. She worked until her death at age 89, with a firm belief, "Each soul must answer to its maker, so I work on in joyful faith. God is still in the business of affecting lives through people. Make yourself available."